Boston, Massachusetts, lighting up the twilight sky. Welcome, everyone. This is what you've been waiting for. The NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by Clark Kimmel, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. And it's Simon in at the four spot. And for the home team, speedy backcourt of Rondo and Bradley, we've got Kirsten. He's thrilled for this one. Everyone will be watching now how he does in his first NBA official game. And it's Coleman in at the power forward.
Provided the details, guys, the way they plan to attack defensively will be key early on, won't it?
Yeah, and early is the key word there, Kevin. If they can string together some stops right away, I think it'll really set the tone.
Which is just what they're going to be after, guys. They love to turn this into a defensive back.
Shot's good from Ramos.
I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass up.
And so here's the home team. It's a three-point game. Passes to Coleman. Back to Grant. Number one, defended by Nixon. Number one. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
And he's such a great distributor of the ball. And, Kevin, his passes aren't just accurate. They're highlight reel dimes. I mean, when he's operating their offense, it is beautiful to watch.
And let's give him some more credit where more credit is due for his role as a team leader. I mean, he's somebody who brings out the best in his teammates whenever he's on the floor.
That free throw, no good. Good on the second free throw. The first quarter of action, 2 minutes in. Here's Nixon. Misses the three. Here's the screen. Number one. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face. Gone 2 or 3 here to start out the game. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Here's Nixon. And so he ends a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Good strength there. Just barely off with that attempt.
I don't think you can fault him right there. A lot of contact on that one.
It's his first trip to the line.
makes the first. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played. Grant outside. Four on the clock. Number one. Offensive rebound. Here's Percy. No problem on the jumping first. Percy's got his first basket of the night.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Shot from the low block. Here's Nixon. Gets rebounded by Coleman.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Number one, defended by Nixon. Pass to Percy. And the layup is good. Percy's got his second bucket. .127 left to play here in the first. Cage passes to Caldwell. Here's Burns. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Gotten 4 of 6 field goal attempts to drop in the first quarter. Kicks it to Arthur. Now the pass to Park. Shot clock at 6. Here's Hicks. Got it off in time and beat the shot clock, but it's no good. .36 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's Cage. And a miss there on the triple.
Not the best shot. Long range and with a defender right in his space. And defensively, that's the kind of work he's known for. I mean, he loves to lock you up.
Gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Caldwell passes to Schultz. Cage. He's guarded by Arthur. Here's Cage. Gets it to go. Well, Clark, we've seen the lead change hands quite a bit in this one.
Yeah, we sure have. I mean, it's been a bit of a windshield wiper game. I mean, back and forth, the lead has gone 5 times, so no one in clear control yet.
I think both teams feel like they can win. They both have confidence. So we'll see which team can kind of ride the momentum and take control of this game.
And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. The away team up 1. And we'll be back right after this. Welcome back, folks. We have a close game here at the start of the second quarter of play. And looking at what we've seen so far, guys, from the visiting team, what do you think?
Big boost from their bench there, guys, in that first quarter. They did a nice job coming in and really giving this team a lift.
Yeah, it's a nice attribute to have. Firepower coming off the pine early. That's good stuff.
And Doris Burke has something for us. Hey, Doris.
Gentlemen, you hear rumors that some in the NBA fraternity consider Blake Griffin a little too nice. Their feeling is that if you get physical with him, you can take him out of his game. It's surprising considering his size and strength. Blake said, "I've never really worried about being called soft. If anybody wants to step up and take that challenge, I'm more than happy off the court because I don't want to get suspended. And guys, he's too valuable to this team to miss games. But some feel he has to retaliate to let opponents know he means business.
That animosity can stick around, Doris. Tough thing. Thank you. Arthur off of it from Park. Shot off a pick. And that one's good.
Solid screen right there that freed him up for the jump shot.
Cage passes to Carney. Here's Burns. Takes the 12-footer and hits.
And they have to mix it up defensively. That was just too easy.
Arthur with it. And we play through the first minute here in the second. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. Arthur's got four this quarter. Arthur's gotten two of his three shots to go tonight. Cage passes to Carter. Here's Burns on the money with the open jumper. He's got six.
That's a nice job of getting the ball in the paint and burying the shot. That's exactly how it's done.
And now approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second quarter. Hicks passes to Park. Shakes him, and the layup is up and in.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening, Steve.
Oh, it's off the charts. It really is. And defensively, I mean, they have to start shutting down some of those lanes in the hoop.
Vicious at the corner. Schultz brings it to Burns. Six to shoot. Sinks that one from the post.
And he's one player who doesn't need a lot of space to get to the basket. He's really crafty. The way he can blast his way straight through traffic, he's really strong.
And another one of his really special talents is coming up with steals at the moment a ball handler picks up his dribble and is getting into a shooting motion. He's got excellent timing in that regard.
Well, it looks like he's finally found his footing in this game. His first quarter was a real struggle, but he's got it going now.
The free throw drops for Arthur. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. It's off his foot. And the official saying it was kicked.
Right there will definitely leave him shaking his head.
Back to Grant. Lock at six. For three. And this serve up and box. Grant's got himself in the doors at 3-2.
And the lead goes right back over. This is a seesaw there. The game's there for the taking, but neither team seems to want it.
Pass to Simon. With the lead pass.
Oh, what a huge play.
Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
Still, I mean, it's startling that he'd even try that right now.
Now let's send it to Doris on the sideline.
Well, guys, the huge trade that really overshadowed this year's draft, the blockbuster deal between the Boston Celtics and the Brooklyn Nets, the Celtics sending out the veteran trio of Jason Terry, receiving three future first-round picks, the right to swap picks in 2017. For the Celtics, a tough but realistic decision to begin the rebuild process. For the Nets, an all-in attempt to win a title. Guys, it sent shockwaves throughout the league. And we'll just have to wait to see how it all shakes out.
They got probably the best team in franchise history. We'll see where they go next. Gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second quarter. Pass to Ramos. It's up a three. That's good. He's got 6.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding. They are piling up the assists.
Here's the dish to Grant. Shoots the three. Can't get it to go.
Boy, he'd like to have that one back.
Got all but one of their 7 shots in the second quarter to drop. Pretty impressive. Morales, the ball's the pressure. The shot's good for Nixon.
Well, he's going to keep banging those home if you give him that much space.
Now 8 seconds separating the 2 clocks. Now Grant. Back, but that 3 is off the mark.
And if they're smart, they will hold for the last shot.
That's got to be the objective here, Steve.
Ramos the pass to Nixon. There's a screen. He passes to Fletcher. And boy, that looked like goaltending. Yes, it is, and so they will award the basket there.
He got there late, but you do have to like the aggressiveness to go after the block. But that one's going to count.
Can you hear the crowd kind of murmuring? I don't think they agreed with the officials on that.
Steve, I tell you what, they're really letting them have it.
And we've reached halftime in this one. The away team up by 6. And it's time now for the Sprint Halftime Show with Damon Bruce. We'll be back shortly to get the second half underway.
Glad you're spending Saturday night with us. Let's check out happened so far. Some good basketball for the away team. They're racking up the assists. Great passing in the early going. And the home club still hanging in there. They've done a great job closing out their defensive possessions, grabbing boards, great rebound. Now let's get back over to Kevin Harlan and the rest of our crew as the second half gets underway.
And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first 2 quarters. You have to like what we're seeing from Burns.
I think like he made everything he got. I mean, anytime he had an open look, he took advantage of the opportunity there in that first half.
And Steve, they were all good looks. I mean, his shot selection has been terrific throughout the game.
With the fadeaway. The shot's good from Simon.
Nice job again that time to add to their lead. I'll tell you what, they're doing everything right at this moment.
They're playing steadily in all aspects of the game, Steve. You're exactly right.
There's the pass to Coleman. Feeds to Grant. Pass to Kersey. 6 to shoot. Rebounded by Fletcher.
Very porous defense down there by the hoop. He probably should make that one.
Passes it to Ramos.
Tell you what, he's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Absolutely insane with that dunk.
Well, now they're starting to rub it in. Aren't they have build up a lead? And here we go, folks. It's showtime.
And why not? I mean, the more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys on the ropes.
Pass to Diaz. Here is Kersey. He dishes it to Grant. He passes to Diaz. From downtown, gets it to go.
Good job creating just enough space to let that one fly.
Gone 3-5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. And we're just about a minute and a half into the third quarter of basketball. The pass to Fletcher. Cartwright's checked in for Kersey. Simon. Defended by Coleman. The shot's good from Simon.
They've been good on all three of their shots since coming out of the locker room at the break.
And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Passes it to Diaz. Inside, here's Coleman. And it is pushed down with a nice jam. They'd love to get more of those, the easiest 2 points possible. And on a fierce finish.
Yeah, and that's exactly how they're going to cut into the lead, Kevin.
Yeah, that's why they've got to tighten up their D. And I'd be surprised if the defense allows any more free runs to the hoop like that.
Nixon, the pass to Ramos. Here's Simon, hits the fadeaway. He has six.
The defense playing way too soft there, guys. He's just getting right to the rim.
Number one, defended by Nixon. He feeds it to Grant. Pass to Cartwright. Defended by Fletcher. Fade away. That's good. Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here.
He did not look too happy about some of the things he saw on the court. So I would expect some changes here.
I think it's the right move, quite honestly. I mean, they just didn't look sharp or at their best out there. So take the time out and give yourself a chance to regroup.
Third quarter here, and 3 minutes have come off the clock. Oh, and there's the...
Ooh, that was awesome!
Look out below.
The solo alley-oop. That's not something we see too often.
Oh, timed it perfectly, you're right, and caught the defense totally off guard.
I can remember Tracy McGrady doing that. First guy I ever saw pull that off.
Five on the clock. Number one. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A 3-point play chance here. This is his second trip to the line in this one.
At the line, one shot.
.130 left in the third. Here's Nixon. And they're going to pop the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
And that's 10 straight points in the paint. I mean, defensively, the wind has just been knocked out of their sails.
Need to get more bodies committed down low.
Gotten four of the first 5 second half shots to fall. 80% since the break. Pass to Percy. Number one, defended by Nixon. And the pass to Hicks. Six on the shot clock. Number one. It's good from Henry. 12 points for him.
You know, he's knocking down his shots today, but it hasn't really translated to the scoreboard yet.
By the Spartans, 6 of 6 in the field since taking the court here in the second half. Nixon, the pass to Morales. Connects, the jumper drops.
They've done a lot of good work with the ball, really moving both the ball and moving bodies, getting quality chances at the hoop.
And they're not wasting chances when they get it. I mean, they're hitting their shots.
Passes it to Kersey. Number one, defended by Nixon. Pass to Kersey. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a 3-point play.
You can see that they're not as aggressive from the 3-point arc. They had far more attempts in the first half.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
Percy. At the line, one shot.
And Kersey, no good on that one. It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Floats one up, and it's good on the way up. He's got 8.
Yeah, not just an everyday finish. He put a little pizzazz on that one, guys.
Pass to Hicks. Lays out. Let's it go from 11. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. First trip to the line for him here.
Well, you know, you'll take what you can from him from the foul line. A season ago, he shot in that low 60% range.
You know, yeah, guys, last year was a rough one for him at the stripe. I mean, it's going to be hard for him not to improve on those numbers. They were that bad.
That free throw missing. Good on the second free throw. Here's Ramos. No good. Well, it's been an exciting game. Plenty of offense as we head to the fourth quarter. The away team leading by 7. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on 2K Sports right after this. And thanks for joining us, folks. The fourth quarter of play should begin momentarily. To the middle. Here's Burke. And he brings it after taking a nice feed on the run.
Major league big boy throwdown right there.
And he keeps a tight grip on that rim after the finish.
And maybe that'll give this team a little bit of their edge back.
Nixon, the pass to Ramos. Backs down. Stolen by Grant. Puts the lead pass in front of him. Hit his leg. And the ref saying he kicked it. And there's the pass to Diaz. Gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. There's the pick. Here's Nixon. Buries the long-range jumper.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a nice look.
Poor job by the defender to not fight over or around that screen.
Passes it to Park. It's picked off. Nixon. He's covered by Grant. And they turn it over. Stepped in the line that time.
You always want a player to have his head up and to be surveying the court, but not if that's going to be the result.
A little over a minute. The fourth quarter gone right now. Number 1, defended by Nixon. The tray. They grant the run miss. Grant the pass to Coleman. That's good.
They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working beautifully.
The defense has been futile with 5 of the last 6 field goals in the lane.
Nixon, the pass to Ramos. Shot clock at 5. Here's Nixon. The rebound by Cartwright.
That's one he knows he should have made.
gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter start. Number one. Gotten a success rate of just over 50% from 3-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting. All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Hi, Kevin. The head coach for the visiting team had some instruction for his guys during that last break. He was absolutely adamant, saying, don't let them off the hook. Let's keep our foot on the pedal and keep doing the things that have gotten us here this far. We're almost home.
Pass to Simon. Makes it off the glass.
Unstoppable offense from both. I love the pace this game has been played at.
So does everybody else in the building. This has been a fun one.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Good point, Kevin. Too many empty trips. They need some points. And that's his second three-pointer of this half. Looks like he's starting to forget about that poor first half he had.
They set the screen. The shot's good for Nixon.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Number one. Terrific design on the pick pick. He lays it in.
You know, the defense didn't exactly try to fight around that screen, and that's why it turned into the easy basket.
We've got 1:48 left to play here in the fourth. Nixon, the pass to Morales. Pocket six. The pass to Nixon. And the hand covers DeJoseph.
He's really rising to the challenge here, guys, in the fourth quarter. That's 3 for 4 from the field.
You have to like what we're seeing from Nixon.
He's definitely rolling offensively. You might not be able to stop him, but you've got to find a way to contain him.
Number one, defended by Nixon. Here's Grant. And it's off from 3-point range. Gone an outstanding 4 of 5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. Pass to Simon. Ramos, who's covered by Grant. They blow the whistle just as he gets it off. That's 2 points with a chance for another one at the stripe.
Good job here. Intentional about, and that's the way you succeed, getting that ball inside.
And the free throw, no good. One oh four left here in the fourth quarter. Number one. And Gordon takes a nice bounce off the right arm and down. He's got 19.
He is setting this place on fire, fellas. This shooting has been off the charts.
Gone 5 of 6 from the field to start the fourth quarter on a roll. Pass to Morales. Six on the shot clock. It's stolen.
Well, it's going to be tough for him, but you have to continue to compete. It's not over. Just play, see what happens.
Yet you can't afford empty possession.
With Diaz, nails it. And now they trail by just 4.
I mean, where's the defense? I mean, this has been pathetic at both ends.
Yeah, it has been pathetic defensively, but it's been exciting from an offensive standpoint. But if you like defense, then neither one of these teams deserves to win.
free throw either. Missing both. This is a huge possession.
You've got to execute under pressure. We're going to see what they're made of.
Here's Park. Money! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
That is a clutch shot if I've ever seen one.
Yeah, very gutsy there. What more can you say? He got it done.
Smart foul there. You got to try to extend the game.
Yeah, it's still close, but they're fighting that clock as much as the score right now.
Number one, defended by Nixon. Here's Grant. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. They foul intentionally. That's what they have to do at this point. Six-point ball game.
And that's exactly how you close a game out. Those free throws will bury them for sure.
And so it's a victory for the road team in this one. Both teams played well, but these guys had the edge.
Yeah, I think so. They were just steak knife sharp. Very on top of their game here.
Well said. And that'll do it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long and thanks for joining us as we leave you with the Jordan Player of the Game.